Hello, it's Keith here, and this is lesson 26 of the platform-specific series of my 650 to assembly tutorials. We've been looking at sound recently. We're going to be looking at the NES and the Famicom this week. Now, on all of my systems within these tutorials, we're going to be learning how to make a little driver I call Chibi Sound, which is a very simple sound driver for creating simple beeps and noise effects in all of our games in a common way across all of the platforms. We're going to be doing the NES this week, and let's have a look at the actual NES hardware and what it can do sound-wise. So, the NES makes it relatively easy for us. If we just want to change our sounds, we just write to these memory map ports that affect the registers of the sound chip. Now, you can see here, there's a wide variety of channels. There's 5 channels, but rather strangely, they all kind of do different things. Now, the first 2 channels are rectangle channels, then there's a triangle channel, there's a noise channel, and then there's a DMC channel, which is for digital data. Now, we're only going to look at the rectangle channel and the noise channel today. We're not going to use the triangle channel or the digital channel. So if you want to play with those other channels, you're totally welcome to. We're also not going to look at the sweep register. This is for panning effects, but as again, we're only doing the real basics today. My theory in all of this is if you want to create more complex sounds, then hopefully this gives you enough of a starting point to do that. But it's really unfortunately outside of my abilities at this time to go into any more depth on so many systems. I'm really covering a quite crazy number of systems at the moment. And, you know, it could take me a week of work to get a single system to a higher standard of this. And unfortunately, I just don't have the time and I can't keep as many systems in memory as I'm working on at the moment. So I'm having to stick to the basics at this point. Okay, so we're going to have a go with the NES and the Famicom this week. Of course, basically the same system. Let's have a look at Chibi Sound in action. Or rather, let's hear Chibi Sound in action. Okay, so you can see here we've got a byte, and this byte is changing. And as it changes, you can see the waveform changing here. Now, this is basically a square wave. Now, the way Chibi Sound works is we pass a single byte to the driver, and the top bit defines whether noise is on or off, and at the moment you can hear it's off. And the next bit will define if the volume is high or low, and it's currently high, but it's about to go to low. And then the remaining bottom 6 bits are the pitch, so you can hear it's getting higher as they get lower. So these are the quiet tones. We're actually running relatively slowly here. The NES driver I'm using here at the moment, it's using only very poor graphics, so it's got a lot of artificial delays in here, so the NES version's running slower than it should. But anyway, we're reaching the bottom of the frequency range, so we're going to soon move into the noise, and we'll have some loud noise in just a moment. So here you can hear the noise. Now, the graduation of the frequencies isn't as smooth, unfortunately, but, you know, as I was saying, it's some fairly adequate noise for our sound effects if we want to do explosions and things. So there we go. That's the output of Chibi Sound. The way Chibi Sound works is really simple. We load a value into the accumulator. The test code here is just showing it to the screen. That's all that does. We then call Chibi Sound with that accumulator. There's a delay. Then we're decreasing the accumulator and we're just looping around. So all of the work is actually being done by this function here. So as I said, we're passing 8 bits to Chibi Sound. The bottom 6 bits are the pitch. The next bit, the 6th bit, is the volume, and then the top bit is the noise. So these bits are being used to define the settings of the actual sound. So what are we going to do? Well, first of all, we're going to take the volume bit, that's this bit here, and then we're going to rotate it to the right too, and we're going to slip it into this position here. Why are we going to do this? Well, we need to set that volume onto either this one here, this port here, hexadecimal 4000, which is the volume and the decay. We're not going to be using envelopes. Envelopes are sort of volume changes over time and things. We're not going to be doing that. We're just doing simple tones. So really all we want to do is these bottom bits here, but we do also need to set these 2 bits to get a constant tone. So we've got 4 bits of definition here, but of course we've only got 1 bit within our definition that we're passing to Chibi Sound. So we're just slipping the 1 bit of definition into this 0 position here for either a low or a high volume. Now we're transferring that to the X register. The reason for that is we don't know where we want to save this to yet. If we're going to make a tone, then we need to save it to 4000. If we're going to make a noise, we need to save it to 400C. So we haven't decided yet, but we're doing this first. Now, part of the reason we're doing this first is we need to know the state of the accumulator, and we don't know whether the flags are set when Tubi Sound starts. So by pushing the accumulator and popping it back, we will have updated the flags. And now we're going to check if all the bits are zero. You see, if all the bits are zero, then Tubi Sound will mute the sound. And the way we do that is we just branch to here, and we store that zero in 4015. 4015 here will actually turn off the sound, you see. Okay, so by storing a zero to 4015, we've muted the sound. Now, at this point, we are now going to check the noise bit, bit 7. So if the bit is set, then we are going to make a noise. If the bit is zero, we're not going to. So the noise version is down here and the regular version is here. Okay, we now know that we're making a tone. So we're going to be making a tone here. So we're going to use that square wave just here, this rectangle wave rather, and we're going to store the volume into hexadecimal 4000. Now what we need to do is we need to swap the nibbles around. Why are we doing this? Well, if you look here, we've got 6 bits of pitch here, just here, and we're going to store the bottom 4 into this register here, and we're going to store the top 2 into this register here. But of course, they're in the opposite positions that we need them to be there. So by swapping the nibbles around, we're actually making it a bit easier for us to get the bits that we need. So what we're doing here is we're selecting those top two bits by anding to filter them out. Then we're ORing the other bits here, setting them all to 1. Now, the reason we're doing this is we're setting the length counter here. We want the tone to be continuous, so we're setting the length to the maximum. And then that's being stored to 403. Now, 403 is this one here, because of course we're doing all our work here with channel 1. Now, what we need to do is we need to do the same to the what were the low bits, but they're now the top bits because of that swap nibble command. We're anding those to keep them, and then we're storing that to 402, which is the low frequency definition for channel 1. Okay, next what we're doing is we're loading the accumulator with a 1 in the low bit here, and we're storing that to 4015. 4015 turns the channel on, and we want to turn on channel 1, this bit here, because of course we've set channel 1 here. And then we are done, so we just return. Now, the alternate version is this noise version here. So in this case, we're storing the volume in X to 40C, which is of course this one here. You'll notice the format's exactly the same, which is why we defined that into the X register. Now what we need to do is we need to set the frequency. Now, the way we're doing this is we are keeping these 4 bits here, and then we're shifting them to the right, and we're storing them in 40E here, into the low bits just here. Now, what we're doing next is we are loading a 1 into this bit here. Now, this is a bit of a trick. Now, what we need to do is we need to set the high frequency bits to 0 here, but we can also set a 1 into this C bit here, and that has no effect. But we also want to turn on channel 4 when we jump to this point here, because we're going to jump to this silent section and store to 4015. So we want this bit to be 1 to turn on channel 4, but we want these bits to be 0, which they were anyway, to set the high frequency bits all to 0. So we're loading the accumulator once, and we're storing it to both 400F and 4015 just here. This has both effects without any extra commands, and that's enough to get the noise working okay. Now, because the 4 bits here are being already loaded into the low frequency range here, I don't know of a better way of getting a better range of noise frequencies. Maybe there is one and I don't know it, but as I say, at the moment, this is the best noise frequency I've been able to get. Anyway, that's all we're going to be looking at today. As I say, if you want to, you could play with the sweep registers and have a go with that, or you could try the triangle one instead, but that's all we're covering today. Now, if you've liked this, please like and subscribe, because we're going to be doing more NES later. We're going to be having a look at hardware sprites. We're also going to be looking at the Super Nintendo with its quite crazy sound capabilities. I say that not necessarily in a good way, because they're very hard to do anything simple on. But anyway, if you've liked this, please like and follow on. Thanks for watching today, and goodbye.